In this video, I'll walk you through how you can configure your old phone, old Java phone, otherwise known as a China phone at this part of the world, to use it and browse. This is an old phone. I'll show you how you can configure it so that it will enable you to browse. As you can see, they have Viscape, Beauty, Facebook, Google, Jabberman, and other things. So you can use the phone and browse after the configuration. One thing about the phone, it doesn't consume much data. So 10 MB can take you for 2 days. So what you do is you put the what I call your internet address. Because we can see issue processing. So wait for a while. So let's configure our small Java phone, otherwise known as China phone, for internet browsing. First of all, check the date of the phone, whether it's correct. If the date is not correct, have to set the date. That's the first thing you need to do. Set the date to correct date, then check whether you have a data. They call it MB, but it's data that can enable you browse. So this is the code you use and check M10 data. Yes, I have bonus of 20 MB here. There's something about this phone, it doesn't consume much data. That's advantage of a Java phone, unlike Android and iPhone and others. So let's do the business proper. You go to connectivity, data accounts, select it, then select option here and edit. So where you see username, this MTN, you put web. Where you see password, you also put web. I'm going to add other ones. The only thing you got to do is to replace them. They're almost the same thing. And check what they call APN as well to change it to your own network. So authentication number, then advanced setting, you have to select it. This is what how the homepage will appear. So we're going to replace this with google.com so that it can take us direct to google, whichever one. I hope you understand what I'm saying. Sorry, this is an old phone. I'm struggling and battling with the button. So anything you do here, remember to save it. So I'm going to select use proxy. So we'll select yes here, then enter proxy address. Proxy address is the same thing as IP address. So what I'm going to add is IP address. The IP address or proxy address of MTN is 10.199.212.2. I take that again. The proxy
address or IP address of MTN is 10.199.212.2. Next for MTN. Check description. I'm going to add other ones there. This is it here. So go to port, proxy port is 8080 for MTN. I think it's the same thing for the Nigerian network. But please check the description. So save after that. So once everything is okay, this APN. This APN is okay. web.gprs.mtnnigeria.net. Let's go to our browser and see whether it will open. Once our browser opens, we are good to go. Open the homepage and wait. Page not available, whatever. Boom! Our browser has opened, but the homepage is not the Google we selected. So the next thing we're going to do is to check that our setting and replace the homepage with Google. Can clear cache and also clear authentication to free some memory of the browser, but this optional, it will not stop you from browsing. So let's go back and check the home page again. Go to connectivity, data accounts, then edit. Scroll down to advanced setting. See, our home page has gone back to the default. So what we are going to do now is to replace it with wap.google.com. Bear with me, the phone is an old phone and this keypad is dancing around. Let's replace this with Google web address and see this time around if we can achieve that. So I'm going to add wap.google.com and save it. Always remember to save any edit or any configuration you make here, because if you don't save it, it won't work. To save, it will be okay. Let's test it again. So that it will take us direct to Google, to internet homepage. Wait for it to open. Boom! This Google has taken us to Google. So you can type anything you want and search for it. That's how it's done.
Thank you. Please subscribe my channel, like and share. If you have any question, please use the comment section. They're good to go. Thank you.